We are gathered here this evening to celebrate our final days of presentation, Secondary School Milltown. As we are set to embark on our new beginning full of opportunities and possibilities into adulthood. Our theme of tonight's prayer service is New Beginnings. Our journey through school has brought us almost to our final destination. However, as we know, there is an exciting and fresh new start about to begin. I have no doubt this new chapter is full of hope for the months and years ahead, and it's only just the start of something amazing. We also take this opportunity to thank our parents, guardians, and teachers for their guidance and support that they have given us. As we venture out into the world of our own individual paths, a quote which comes to mind is one by T.S. Eliot. For last year's words belong to last year's language, and next year's words await another voice. And to make an end is to make a new beginning. Tonight, as we take our first step on this new journey, we reflect on some of the memorable features that have made the class of 2021 who we are today. In this procession, several of the graduates will bring to the altar symbols of our journey together. Jordan brings a Bible and a lantern, symbolising the ethos of the school, which is rooted in the faith of the Venerable Nan O'Lagle and Blessed Edmund Rice. Let us now go forward into our new chapter, guided and supported by God. Cunnell holds a football, which represents the sporting and leisure activities, which are an important part of our school life. Through these sports, we have learnt in different ways the importance of recreation and teamwork. Moira brings a compass, which symbolises the many different directions we will embark on during this new adventure, but we are ultimately all tied together by our joint memories. Carla carries a class photo, which symbolises not only the class itself, but the bonds and friendships that exist between this class. In Pres Milltown, we are rooted in the culture of the area, and which is a rural culture. Sean brings a small chapter symbolising the pride that our students have in where they come from. Anthony carries forward a bowl of seeds. This represents the way we are nurtured and have grown within the school in the past 5 to 6 years. Katie brings a mask to the altar. This, without a doubt, is something which has played a predominant role in all our lives this past year. However, this mask does not just symbolise the despair which we have suffered, but our resilience in the face of these challenges.
Sincere welcome to both you, the students, your families, and all who are gathered watching this evening. For some, this day has arrived not only after a brief time, but a lifetime for one and all. It's a cumulation of a joint effort of parents, of students, of teachers, and of friends. And this evening we're here to remember, to pray, and to think and hope about the future. And we thank God for our time together. We thank God for the friends we have made. We thank God for all we have learned about life from our parents, our teachers, and indeed from each other. And we're here too so that we can pray for each other, for the happiness of each of us, for the future. We pray also for ourselves in the coming exams, for peace of mind, and for success in each of them. And we look ahead. That's the most important thing. We look ahead to new beginnings, trusting in God With a sense of joy and thanks, we now begin our prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all, and with your spirit. Let us pray. Father, you have filled the hearts of your people with faith, hope, and love. Hear the prayers we offer you for the class of 2021. Bless the work they have done and will do in the coming weeks, months, and years. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
First reading, a reading from the Colossians, chapter 3, verse 12 to 14. You are God's chosen people. Always be ready to care for others and to be kind and gentle. Be patient and calm and never boast about or be proud of your goodness. Just as God always forgives you, so you must always be forgiving towards others. Fill your hearts with love. Whatever you do, do it for God. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
This world's a hill. Second reading, a reading from the Romans. Do not let your love be a pretense, but sincerely prefer good to evil. Love each other as much as brothers and sisters should, and have a profound respect for each other. Work for the Lord with untiring effort and with great earnestness of spirit. If you have hope, this will make you cheerful. Do not give up if trials come, and keep on praying. If any of the saints are in need, you must share with them, and you should make hospitality your special care. Bless those who persecute you, never curse them. Bless them. Rejoice with those who rejoice, and be sad with those in sorrow. Treat everyone with equal kindness. Never be condescending, but make real friends with the poor. Do not allow yourself to become self-satisfied. Never repay evil with evil, but let everyone see that you are only interested in the highest ideals. Do all you can to live at peace with everyone. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you all. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory be to thee, O Lord. Jesus said, I am telling you not to worry about your life and what you are to eat, or about your body and what you are to wear. Surely life is more than food, and body more than clothing. Look at the birds in the sky. They do not sow or reap or gather into barns, yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not worth more than they are? Do not worry. Do not say, what are we to eat, and what are we to drink? What are we to wear? Set your hearts on God's kingdom first, and on his saving justice, and all other things will be given you as well. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. New beginnings. A friend of mine, I worked for 10 years in Kenya, in Africa. And a young boy there, a young man, he was in secondary school, he wanted to become a priest. His name was David Cheruiyot. His second name doesn't matter, the different to Broderick or McCarthy. But David became a priest, and he became a missionary priest. And he studied in South Africa. And from Kenya, if you study geography, Nigeria is right across the north of Kenya, the north of Africa. He became a priest, and today he is working in a place called Abuja in Nigeria. And every now and again, David gives me a ring on the mobile phone. And he's speaking from Abuja in Nigeria, I don't know how many thousand miles away. And the phone call is as clear as I'm talking to you now. And then after about a half an hour talking to David on the phone and how he's managing in his parish, I might ring my brother at home, which is only about 4 miles away, and I mightn't be able to get through at all on the phone. And I often ask myself, what is wrong with that? Modern communications are powerful, but sometimes they don't work as good as we'd like them to be. And as I talk to Father David on the phone, so far away, I think of when I try to talk to God in my own little way. And I think that when I'm talking to God, I don't need a mobile phone, I don't need a Facebook, or I don't need all the modern communications, which are powerful when they're used, they're powerful. But what we need to talk to God is a human heart, a heart that is open, a generous heart, a heart that is kind, a heart that is forgiving, and a heart that will turn to God to say thanks to him and to ask him. And as you go out into the world, having done your leaving cert, if you say a little prayer any day, let it always begin with a thanks. Say thanks. Thank you, God, for what you're giving to me, for all that has been happening in the school, for your friends, your teachers, your parents, all the people that have been guiding you. And thank you, Lord, for your health. And thank you for this particular year that has gone, which has been difficult with COVID and everything. The leaving cert has taken slightly different this year. But thank God, too, for kind of managing all of that for you this year.
And that's the one word I would like you to carry with you today. Just thanks. I think God looks down on us and he says to us, you're always asking for things. Why are you asking all the time? I want this and I want that, and why isn't it this way or that way? And he's saying, be grateful first and say thanks. And you have a lovely theme for today, new beginnings. Every step in life is a new beginning. Going to secondary school, going on through it, doing exams, doing the leaving, moving on into a new way of life, into a new beginning. And I just want to wish you well in your exams, and after the exams, enjoy your holidays, and wherever you will be in September, I know that from what I see with the talents and gifts that you have, it will be great. There's a lovely, powerful future out there for you with new beginnings. May God be always thankful and grateful, and may God guide you on that powerful journey. Take care.
We dedicate this poem to all those who have lost their lives due to COVID-19. We also take a moment to reflect on the selflessness and courage of those working in frontline services as they lead us bravely to brighter days ahead. This poem reminds us to be hopeful. Everything is going to be all right. How should I not be glad to contemplate the clouds clearing beyond the dormer window and a high tide reflected on the ceiling? The poems flow from the hand unbidden, and the hidden source is a watchful heart. The sun rises in spite of everything, and the far cities are beautiful and bright. I lie here in a riot of sunlight, watching the daybreak and the clouds flying. Everything is going to be all right. Creed to live by. Don't undermine your worth by comparing yourself with others. It is because we are different that each of us are special. Don't set your goals by what other people deem important. Only do what is best for you. Don't take for granted the things closest to your heart. Cling to them as you would your life, for without them, life is meaningless. Don't let life slip through your fingers by living in the past or in the future. By living one day at a time, you live all days of your life. Don't give up when you still have something to give. Nothing is really over until the moment you stop trying. Don't be afraid to admit that you are less than perfect. It is the fragile thread that binds us to each other. Don't be afraid to encounter risks. It is by taking chances that we learn how to be brave. Don't shut love out of your life by saying it is impossible. The fastest way to lose love is to hold it tightly. And the best way to keep love is to give it wings. Don't dismiss your dreams. To be without dreams is to be without hope. To be without hope is to be without purpose. Don't run through life so fast that you forget not only where you've been, but also where you are going. Life is not a race, but a journey to be savored each step of the way.
For our final blessing for this part of the ceremony. Could I ask you just to be quiet in your hearts for a moment and just to think and just to look back over your years in the school and all the wonderful people you've met, your friends, your teachers, your parents and all your families. And just think of one or two things that you'd like to say thanks for today. And just ask God for what you want for your exams and for the future. There may be one subject that you're a little bit worried about, ask for direction in that subject. There may be something else that you'd like to ask for today. Just ask for one little prayer, Lord, grant me this in the next while. I invite you just to say amen to each of the blessings. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Lord bless you and keep you. Amen. May he let his face shine upon you and show you his mercy. Amen. May he turn his countenance towards you and give you his peace. Amen. May Almighty God bless you all. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'd like to begin by thanking Father Danny and Reverend Bradley and all of our wonderful students and staff for the beautiful service this evening. Whether it was reading, bringing up the gifts, our wonderful musicians, or any part that was played in the background, thank you to you all. We thank everyone who is joining remotely this evening, students, teachers, parents, guardians, family members and friends. We would, of course, have loved to have had you all here in the church with us this evening, but obviously circumstances do not allow. Our sixth year students are probably tired of hearing me talk about COVID, so as much as possible, I'll try not to focus on the COVID elements of your school days. But I do want to take this opportunity to acknowledge your adaptability, your strength, determination, and resilience over the course of fifth and sixth year, as you took on the challenge of sanitizers, face masks, wipes, social distancing, and dare I even mention, the dreaded remote learning. We really are very proud of you all. As your graduation theme of New Beginning implies, life is a journey made up of beginnings, endings, and more new beginnings. The day you were born marked a new beginning for you, your parents, and your family. As babies and young children, they mapped out your journey and made decisions for you. As you grew, they taught you the basic life skills: feeding yourself, walking, running, talking. As you got older again, you became more able to make your own decisions, but they were always there to guide you, to help you make the right decision. While tonight is very much about looking forward to the next stage of your journey, to the next new beginning, it is also important to look back and acknowledge the role that your parents and guardians have played in bringing you to this stage. The past year or so has been challenging in so many ways, and the next few weeks may themselves bring some difficult and challenging moments as the reality of the Leaving Cert exams sink in. Like your parents, we are all very proud that so many of you have chosen to sit the Leaving Cert exams. This may cause you to feel a bit of pressure with last-minute revision. But please remember that for every ounce of stress or pressure you feel, your parents are feeling it 100 times over. You may lose a bit of sleep with some late-night cramming, but over the years, your parents have lost countless nights of sleep worrying about you and caring for you. While we really are so very sorry that you're not all here with us in the church this evening, it is in some strange way very apt that most of you will be spending tonight at home with your families and those who care about you. I would ask you to use this evening to show your appreciation in some small way for all they have done to get you here, to get you this far, to get you ready for your next new beginning. Moving from primary school to secondary school was another new beginning in your lives and where your journey with us began. When it came to choosing your secondary school, your parents could have sent you anywhere. They trusted us and they chose to send you to Presentation Milltown. Parents, we thank you sincerely for that trust and for allowing us the privilege of sharing in your sons and daughters' lives over the last 5 and 6 years. In preparing for this evening, I know that our students have been revisiting the many fond memories that they shared as a year group since their time here began. While the secondary school journey is undoubtedly about academia, exam results, and getting you to college or to work, we hope that your presentation memories and learning contained much, much more than academia, topics from the curriculum, and COVID measures. We hope that you have learned what it means to be a good and supportive friend. It's certainly something that Miss Coyle, your yearhead, has been very proud of with this particular group, that you look out for each other and support one another. We hope that you have learned the importance of being kind, tolerant, honest, understanding, and considerate. As well as you learning from us during your time here at Pres Milltown, we have learned from you. As individuals, you have put so much into your time here. Some of you excelled in science, music, sports, maybe art. For others of you, it's your strength and determination that will form our memories of you. And for so, so many of you, it will be your kindness and consideration of others that we will remember when we look back on the class of 2021. As you reflect, for some of you, your memories will show the journey through secondary school as being smooth, comfortable, and we hope enjoyable. Maybe with a few gradual hills here and there to climb and overcome. For others, the road may have been much more rocky and uncertain, with many uphill struggles. We hope that however you found that journey, you felt supported and cared for during your time here. We hope that you felt that even when things went a little bit wrong, there was always an opportunity to do better tomorrow, the opportunity to begin anew. As you leave us and move on to your next new beginning, the next stage of your journey, you will come to realise that throughout life, some paths will be smooth and comfortable and others will be bumpy and uncertain. It is inevitable for all of us that we will make decisions that bring us down a road we initially think is right, but then realise it's not for us. Remember that while many new beginnings come our way as part of the natural course of life, primary school, secondary school, moving on to college or work. The really important new beginnings don't just happen. They are created, and they are created by you. Each new day, each fresh sunrise provides an opportunity to start again, a new beginning. Over the past 5 and 6 years, we have watched you grow with each new year, each new term, each new day. We have watched you grow into strong, enthusiastic, confident young men and women. We have watched you overcome diversity and challenge with energy and resilience. We have watched you develop the ability to see the positive side of any difficult situation. We have watched you grow into young men and women who are kind, considerate, and compassionate towards others. With every ending comes a new beginning. As you end your journey with us at Presentation Milltown and face into another major new beginning in your lives, remember that each and every day provides the opportunity to begin again, to begin anew. We wish you well, class of 2021. May your journey through life have but few difficult endings and many, many bright new beginnings.
Good evening, Father Broderick, Deacon Bradley, Miss Hart and Mr. Costello, teachers, parents, family and friends, and all those of you joining us online for this special evening. On behalf of Aisling and I, we wish to extend a warm welcome to you all and thank you for joining us this evening to celebrate the graduation of the class of 2021. Our chosen theme, New Beginnings, resonates deeply with us all as we six-year students say goodbye to this chapter of our lives here spent in Presentation Secondary School in Milltown and say hello to the many new beginnings that the next chapter offers. This graduation class of 2021 are well prepared for these new beginnings. We are unique. We are making history. In just 2 weeks' time, we will be the first Leaving Cert class to sit the traditional Leaving Cert during a pandemic. Are we ready? Of course we're ready. We have shown ourselves to be a tremendously strong year group. Over the past year, we have endured uncertainty, negotiated the world of online learning, and adapted to the new normal of masks, sanitizers, and 2 meter social distancing from our best friends. This adaptability, flexibility, and resilience that is so present in this group has been hugely influenced by our school. In Pres Milltown, we have grown from young children who needed to be minded, guided, and handheld into mature young people with our own distinct personalities, ideas, and viewpoints. We have learned to stand on our own 2 feet, to be independent, and to face new beginnings with fearlessness and hope. I suppose we didn't show many signs of that fearlessness when we first walked through the gates of the school, Aisling.
No, Ethan. I'd say that many of us arrived feeling a little scared and overwhelmed. We went from being a big fish in primary to the tiniest fish in the ocean of secondary. We grappled with getting lost, forgetting books, and figuring out the day the homework was due. But our TY buddies stepped in to help us navigate the corridors and awkward social situations so that by Christmas we'd grown in confidence and some would say exuberance. We gained a reputation for being the strong and silent types. Silent in the classroom but a bit boisterous on the corridors. We were apparently kinesthetic learners, so we excelled in the realm of drama and sport. The TY show allowed the thespians among us to shine. There were dancing grannies, those who didn't like Mondays, a Mad Hatter Kerry tea party featuring our famous local politicians, even the Great Depression turned out to be not so depressing after all. In sport, there were gold medals in athletics, the lads did us proud at the county football blitz, while the girls brought glory to the school in their first year by winning the All-Ireland Minor B basketball championships. These victories meant that we made our way into second year with confidence. We were no longer the newbies, but now fully fledged Milltown students. We were introduced to the new acronym which became the bane of our lives, the CBA. CBAs were now not only in English, but in science and business as well. By the end of the year, we were ideally prepared to give an oral presentation on splitting the atom with a budget plan as to its costing. But it was our trip to Barcelona which solidified our friendships and gave the year a focus. As we saved and planned, planned and saved. The only frustrating element was that Sergi, who had come to the school from Barcelona to learn English, and who we now considered to be one of our own, could not come with us. He was disappointed, but we took plenty of photos to send to him as we took the city bus tour, visited New Camp and the Gaudi Basilica. On board the bus, we accepted the back seat bans with a smile, talks of swear jars made sure we spoke only our best Spanish, and we all had our own theories on the mystery of the Fuerteventura missing locker contents. Our palates were introduced to new and exotic fruits during the breakfast buffet, but figuring out which were the edible parts of the melon required the assistance of at least one science teacher. It was a fun-filled trip from beginning to end, so much so that one student stayed on board afterwards, meeting up with the pilots and checking out the cockpit in the hope of getting a stint of some cool work experience. And in the end, even Sergi was happy when he returned home in May wearing his signed Kerry jersey on the streets of Barcelona. In Turger, we discovered our ambitious gene, with everyone getting fully on board to work hard as we faced into our first state exam. The new word this year was deadlines. Woodwork, art, science, religion all demanded that at a certain time, on a certain date, the work would have to be done. We rose to the challenge with diligence and commitment, and some enthusiastic students even took a day out of their Christmas holidays to stay in school for an extra day. The year ended with the dreaded junior cert, which ended up not being so dreadful at all, and we came through it with flying colours. Fifth year meant that some of us chose to do TY and departed from us, but as we bid them farewell, we welcomed the members of previous TY class to join us in our new beginnings as senior cycles.
To help with our integration, events such as the Bookfest in Listowel and ice skating in Cork were organised. Billy Murphy's talk in Listowel was the nearest we got to Cork though, as we never crossed the county bounds, and found ourselves instead on a bus turning into the Tesco car park in Clarney for the Cork ice skating outing. We had great fun there, and it was days like these that helped to bring us together. But as in life, it is sport more than anything that truly creates a sense of camaraderie and belonging. Our support for our boys' football team had never wavered over the years, as each year in every competition they got better and edged closer to victory. That elusive victory became a reality when they found themselves in the final of the Dunlow Cup facing the arch rivals, the SEM. They gave a stunning performance on the day, and the score, Milltown 213, St. Brendan's 8 points, left us in no doubt as to who were the true champions. They were ecstatic. We were ecstatic. The whole school was ecstatic. The team, their coaches and mentors brought glory and honour to not only our year group, but the whole school, by winning the first A title in the school's history on December 4th, 2019. Speaking of significant dates, Thursday, March 2020 will be forever embedded in our collective memory. The Taoiseach announced that all schools in Ireland were to be closed by that Thursday evening, and while the public queued for bread, toilet paper and pasta, our teachers queued for the photocopiers, and we were given reams of notes and a two-week study plan. Let's be honest, at the time, we were secretly thrilled at the prospect of what we thought might be an extended Easter break, but nobody would have dreamt it would be 6 months before we would walk through those school gates again, and what a learning curve we had during those final weeks of fifth year. We had to begin to learn in a new way yet again. Microsoft Teams was our new buzzword as we began to learn to work independently and submit our schoolwork online. We were proud of our resourcefulness in being able to negotiate this new way of learning, but we missed our friends. We missed the class banter, missed the training sessions, missed engaging with our teachers. Most of all, can you believe it, we missed school. When we did return on the 2nd of September, wearing our masks and strictly adhering to COVID guidelines, we were so thrilled. We were happy to be with each other, happy to learn our track victory, complete field studies and projects, happy to be back in our routine. Who cared if there were lunchtime pods, if every window and door of each classroom remained wide open and we had to endure gale force winds? We wore our layers, our coats and beanies, and braved mask breaks in the great outdoors. Then it was November tests, Christmas, and oh no, lockdown again. For a generation who spend as much time as we do online, we were very shy turning on those cameras. With much persuasion, we rose to the challenge, though at times it was exhausting. So it was back to Teams again, no mocks, and eventually relief at the option of accredited grades. We've been back now since March, with some questionable DIY haircuts, with our eyes fixed firmly on portals and deadlines, but we are back and we are together, and that's all that matters till this chapter of our story ends.
From our first day in Pres Milltown till tonight, we've been so aware that we were not taking this journey alone. We knew that we were being minded and guided, and especially during these last 2 years. We are truly grateful to those who have helped us on our way since we began as first years here in school. To our principal, Ms. Harkin, and our deputy, Mr. Costello, we say a very big thank you. Your hard work and dedication are appreciated by all of us. Your strong leadership, the respect that you have shown to each and every one of us, has ensured that we have felt cared for and valued in this, our school. To our yearhead, Ms. Coyle, we say thank you. Your fairness was the quality that stood out for us from day one. You set the bar high. Uniforms had to be perfect. We had to be on time for class and homework had to be done. But along with making sure we followed the rules, you made it known that your door was always open if we ever needed help or even a quick chat. Your kindness will be remembered by us long after we have left. To our teachers, we say thank you. Not only for your work in class and online, but for all the extra effort you made to help us on those long afternoons spent after school, preparing Leaving Cert projects, practicals, and orals. We thank you for the commitment, patience, and flexibility you have shown throughout this challenging year. Your commitment to us has never wavered. You always had our best interests at heart, and the high expectations you held for us helped us to strive to achieve our goals. We owe an incredible debt of gratitude to all the teachers that have helped us along this sometimes challenging journey. And our graduation would not be complete if we didn't say thank you to Breda, our secretary, Limor, caretaker, and Eleanor and Margaret in the canteen, whose patience and good humour have cheered us up on many a dark winter's day. This evening is a special evening, not just for the class of 2021, but also for our parents. We would not have managed these past 2 years without you. Your support made lockdown bearable. Your unstinting support for us has been remarkable, as you did everything in your power to make navigating these uncharted waters of 2021 Leaving Cert easier for all of us. Thank you for the numerous cups of tea, the lunches, the Friday night takeaways, the hugs when we missed yet another 18th birthday party, the list goes on. Thank you for your patience and your strength. It emboldened us and helped us cope.
So 6 years, class of 2021, the time has come for us to part and to begin again. We must leave behind the people that we have come to know and care about here in Presentation Secondary School Milltown. But in our hearts, we will take the spirit of the school along with us as we begin anew. We finish tonight with the words of our Kerry poet, Brendan Kennelly. And as our country slowly returns to normal, let us too take our place and begin our final step into adulthood. Though we live in a world that dreams of ending, that always seems about to give in, something that will not acknowledge conclusion insists that we forever begin.
On behalf of the Leaving Cert class of 2021, we would like to acknowledge our yearhead, Ms. Coyle, our principal, Ms. Harkin, and our deputy principal, Mr. Costello. As a token of our appreciation for all they have done for us in Presentation Milltown, we present them with these gifts.
Sleeps at night, it's time to begin, isn't it? I get a little through miles of clouded hell right to the top. Don't look back. Turning to right and giving the commodities a rain check. I don't ever want to let you down. I don't ever want to leave this town. 'Cause after all, the city never sleeps at night. It's time to begin, isn't it? I get a little bit bigger, but then I'll admit I'm just the same as I was. Now don't you understand? But I'm never changing who I am. It's time to begin, isn't it? I get a little bit bigger, but then I'll admit I'm just the same as I was. Now don't you understand? And I'm never changing who I am. This road never looked so lonely. This house doesn't burn down slowly to ashes, to ashes. It's time to begin, isn't it? I get a little bit bigger, but then I'll admit I'm just the same as I was. Now don't you understand that I'm never changing who I am? It's time to begin, isn't it? I get a little bit bigger, but then I'll admit I'm just the same as I was. Now don't you understand that I'm never changing who I am?
Ha ha ha!